Many businesses consider cybersecurity risks as one of the top risks facing their organizations. Spending on cybersecurity has been forecast to reach $1 trillion for the five-year period ending next year, and direct costs of cyber attacks are estimated to hit $6 trillion by next year as well. And that estimate is probably conservative, given the dramatic increase we're seeing in cyber attacks during this COVID-19 crisis. In Rahm Emanuel's footsteps, never letting a serious crisis go to waste, cyber criminals have decided to take advantage of the increased vulnerabilities in the system caused by the rapid and massive shift to a work-from-home environment and by people's increased susceptibility to phishing attacks due to their interest and perhaps anxiety over COVID-19. So how do company directors and executives help prevent the COVID crisis from turning into a cyber crisis? I'd like to offer three thoughts. First, by taking direct responsibility for overseeing the development and management of implementation of a holistic plan to enhance the organization's cyber resilience in this new world, with a focus on securing the remote working environment and extensive continuous training of employees. This is not just a matter for the IT security team anymore. Really, this is a board and CEO level responsibility. Second, by leveraging the wisdom of the crowd, encouraging your IT security team to speak to peers, to share lessons learned, and to seek some guidance from specialized cybersecurity firms if you feel you may need more help with an assessment of your existing infrastructure or the development and implementation of your new plan. Most cybersecurity solutions rely on locks on the door to keep the bad guys away. This is certainly necessary, but not sufficient for optimal cyber resilience. Regardless of how many locks you have, bad guys will eventually break in, or more likely be welcomed in by your employees through an errant click on a malicious link in a phishing email, or the bad guys are already sitting inside your network or company. So finally, what is also required, in my opinion, to mitigate damages from cyber attacks is a professional monitoring and incident response capability from a highly trained team of forensic analysts and incident response experts. And those teams are typically found in specialized third-party providers of such services. Think of this as a highly effective form of cyber insurance. I think that implementing these steps quickly and with confidence can make the difference between surviving one or two crises, or for some companies, not surviving at all.